I'm Soledad O'Brien. Welcome to Matter of Fact. Nearly 70% of consumers are already using artificial intelligence technology, or AI, and they don't even know it. That's according to Deloitte. AI is being used to refer patients to doctors, to determine if you qualify for life insurance. AI is big business for tech companies, and it's expected to get even bigger. But facial recognition, one aspect of AI, is drawing lots of concern. The algorithm that powers facial recognition has never been perfect, yet there are few scientific or government regulations to make it better. MIT researcher Joy Buolamwini says racial bias is also baked into AI coding. When did you start studying artificial intelligence?
Well, I got into artificial intelligence more so through art projects. I came to the MIT Media Lab and I was really excited to take courses that looked at both art and science. So I started a course called Science Fabrication. And the idea was you read science fiction and you try to build something you probably wouldn't be able to otherwise. So I built something called an Aspire Mirror. And the idea was for the Aspire Mirror, I could look at what seemed like a regular mirror and put anything I wanted onto my face.
Your face would come up and then Serena Williams' face would be superimposed on top of yours and ta-da, there's
your
Aspire
Mirror. And
then I
would be the greatest of all time, right?
Good way to start your morning.
Great way to start the morning. So this is what I was trying to do. I was trying to apply existing technology into an art project. And while I was doing that, I ran into the issue of having to wear a white mask to have my face detected.
Why? What do you mean? What happened?
I was using a webcam, and the webcam had to have some computer vision software so it could track my face. But instead of following my face, it did nothing. So this is what got me into questioning, why am I having a different experience with technology that I would otherwise think is neutral?
What exactly is artificial intelligence?
Essentially, it's giving machines automated abilities to perceive or to also have some kind of discernment, right? So part of artificial intelligence can be thinking about how do you let machines communicate? So understanding language, whether it's language that's written or something like Siri, where you're talking to your phone to have the computer understand you in some way.
So did it become clear to you that AI was biased?
Well, this is the question I was curious about. I started testing AI systems from Microsoft, from IBM, and from Face++, a leading billion-dollar tech company in China that's used by the government for surveillance.
And what'd you find?
I found that it wasn't just my face, right? It was, overall, the systems work better on male faces than female faces. They work better on lighter faces than darker faces. And they worked especially poorly on darker female faces. So you didn't have error rates that exceeded more than 1% for lighter skinned men, but you had error rates as high as 35% for darker skinned women.
So did you go back to the tech companies and say, you have a problem?
So IBM got back to me within 24 hours and said, we acknowledge this is important. We're going to look into it. When they looked into it and they replicated our study, they found similar results. And so they invited me to speak to their senior technologist and some of their executives. And they then rolled out a new product that was substantially better.
Amazon has a program called Recognition.
Yes.
And you reached out to Jeff Bezos about that.
We felt it was extremely urgent to reach out to Amazon because they are currently selling recognition to police departments right now. In follow-up studies we did, we even showed that Amazon was not getting Oprah's face correct.
If you're failing on Oprah's face, you cannot have very good software.
I would question it highly, for sure.
Is the idea that human beings are biased, so anybody who's a programmer is bringing their bias into this program, and if it's AI, it's really human bias that's just being reflected.
I call it the coded gaze, right? The coded gaze, like the male gaze or the white gaze, reflects the priorities, reflects the preferences, and also reflects the prejudices of those who have the power to shape technology.
You wanted a moratorium on this.
Absolutely.
Technology.
So right now, because of what we know about the errors with facial recognition technology,
it's clearly biased.
Clearly biased. It's being used right now. It's being shown not to be effective, and there's no oversight. So until we have processes where we can actually see, is the technology working as we intend it to? And do we have continuous reports so we see the technologies not being abused? I definitely believe there should be a moratorium as we work on having federal standards and regulations for this kind of technology.
Joy Buolamwini, nice to meet you. Thanks so much.
Thank you.